And Letty here. Today I'm going to share with you hashtag crafty goals 2023. This is an 8x8 paper pad smash. It's Violet Studio Designs and it's called Happy Easter. So welcome back everyone. I am participating in hashtag crafty goals 2023. One of my goals is to smash small paper pads. I've got this Happy Easter by Violet Studios. It was a scrapbook.com freebie, so I got it free with one of my orders. It is Easter themed. It has 10 different designs. You get 3 of each of the designs. It's not full on cardstock. It's more like a paperweight. It is single-sided, so it's not double-sided, just single-sided. So again, it's called Happy Easter by Violet Studio Designs from scrapbook.com. So then I also took out some stamp sets. These are Easter themed stamps that I have in my stash. I wanted to make tags, so I took out this To From stamp by Rosie Studio. I took out a Pink in Maine that has some spring sayings. That's what it's called, spring sayings. Thought that was cute. And then I took out some Lawn Fawn stamps. I like that little Easter basket. I took out some additional stamps that I had purchased at Tuesday morning. So, and then I wanted to show, so I've already done 4 cards with this, and you probably saw this video a few weeks ago. This was the paper pad that I used for those backgrounds. And I also showcased that Just For You stamp by Not Too Shabby. I have a website link and a discount code down in the description box below. So for this paper pad, again, you get 10 designs. It's 8x8 paper. It is single-sided. So I'm going to show you here real quick. It is white on the back. So it's perfect for card making because we only really need one side. I have a few scraps left over. Those were from when I made my initial 4 cards previously on a design team video. And then I've already cut out some tags. I've got 60 tags. So what I did for my first project was make these tags. And I made them off camera and made them really quick. And I've already sent them out because I needed to get them over to my mom who was gonna make some cookies and needed tags. So I have these tags. So you see here, I stamped in a couple different colors. I added a piece of that scrap paper at the bottom, and then I added a stamped image right on top. I did add a little bit of glossy accents to these. I really like the way these tulips, they're just so cute. And then I also brought in a flower stamp. I'll show you in just a second. So I brought in some stamps. I made some tags. I made a ton of tags. 60 total to send over to my mom. And again, I don't have these in my final like recap in just a few seconds because I've already sent them out, already mailed them to her. But I did use this Lawn Fawn stamp set. It's called Easter Before and Afters. I use that little Easter bunny basket. And then I use the To and from this Rosie Studio stamp. And then I also used that floral image from the Hey Lady stamp set from Not Too Shabby. This was in the box of the month last month for February. And then I also brought in the tulips from Just For You and the die set, which is this month's stamp and die from Not Too Shabby. I brought in 2 of these Easter sayings from the spring saying stamp set by Pink in Maine. I think I purchased that at Not Too Shabby as well. So again, I made 60 tags, just giving you a little preview since I will not have them for the final recap in just a second. So again, this was the Happy Easter by Violet Studio Designs. This was an 8x8 paper pad. I did smash the whole thing, which was 30 pages. It was brand new when I started. So I want to show you everything that I made using this pad as part of my crafty goals. Here are my scraps that I had left over. That was it. That was really it. And I probably didn't even need to have those scraps. I probably just didn't add them on my tags. But I did end up using the same stamps I had already showed you in the previous segment of this video where I showed which ones I used. So just as, again, in case you were interested, those are the stamps that I did end up using for these projects. Let me do a full recap of everything I made. So again, I had those 4 original cards from my Not Too Shabby design team project. And so these were what those 4 cards looked like. Just used them as the backgrounds, just gorgeous tulips. And then I also made 3 easy little Easter journals. So I just had these 4x4 cut aparts and I thought they would be great on this sheet of paper specifically. And I didn't want to make cards with it, so I made them into little bitty journals that I would give to my 3 nieces. I used staples for the binding, very, very basic, nothing fancy here at all. Then here is just a quick little screenshot of the 60 Easter tags that I've already made and I sent out already separately. And then I made an additional 39 A2 size Easter or encouragement cards. I added some doodle lines. I added some stamped images. I basically cut down my large A2 size mat, which was 4 inches by 5 1/4. And it did leave me a segment at the very top, which I'm using for those kind of back rectangles that you see in the background. I stamped some images on some of the little cut aparts. Those little cut-aparts are what came in the actual paper pad. I think you got like 9 to 1 sheet. So I have 3 different of each design of the cards for the most part. Occasionally I change it up a little bit, but for the most part I got 3 of each design, which is what I'm showing you here. So just really basic cards, really easy going. Here is a couple different variations of that card. And then again, I just use my stamps to stamp some images and some sentiments on the images. I did color them and I fussy cut them and then added them to these cards. I thought that just added an extra little touch and just brought back in that Easter feel for some of those designs. Then I had some of those 4x4 cut aparts and I had some scraps, so I went ahead and turned them into some cards. These were so quick and easy to make. Once I started cutting down that paper pad, it went so super quick. So super quick. So there's a couple different variations of that. And then for these last 3, I didn't have any cut aparts. I added a smile. I think you're awesome, because I thought these would be great to just include in my Cards for Cubs donation that I'm wrapping up right now. So again, 43 cards, 60 tags, 3 journals, 106 total items. This was the Hoppy Easter by Violet Studio Designs. It was a 8x8 paper pad smash as part of my hashtag Crafty Goals 2023. Thanks for visiting, everyone. I hope you subscribe, like this video, follow me on Instagram. Here are a couple videos I think you might enjoy, and happy crafting!